An update for you all. Last week, the man featured in our voter fraud report was arrested following a warrant issued by the New Hampshire Attorney General, Gordon McDonald.
He early voted in Florida in 2018, and then he voted in person in the polls here in New Hampshire.
I guess I did.
Robert Bell, the man who voted in both Florida and New Hampshire in 2018, was charged with a Class B felony, the New Hampshire Attorney General breaking the news 4 o'clock on Good Friday. Criminal charges were brought against the man for voter fraud, but only after having been exposed by a Project Veritas investigation. The same day we released our voter fraud story about Mr. Bell, the AG's office issued grand jury subpoenas to us. They recognized our investigative prowess by arresting Bell, but ironically appear to have an issue with our investigative journalism and the First Amendment. We were perplexed. The New Hampshire Union Leader independently reported that the subpoena may stem from a 2016 investigation into the Bernie Sanders campaign. Quote, a person familiar with the Attorney General's work on the matter said that the agency had an open investigation into Project Veritas's secret recording. It was deja vu all over again, because in March of 2016, after releasing a voter fraud story in New Hampshire, the AG's office issued me a subpoena demanding our raw videos from a man named Dick Tracy, same guy who's issuing this current subpoena. But funny enough, we had already delivered them to state officials. In April of 2016, Veritas sent a sworn affidavit to Assistant Attorney General Stephen Labonte with a request to have Project Veritas Action and myself excused from appearing before a grand jury. Labonte replied saying, quote, I believe the previously served grand jury subpoena has been satisfied. As such, Mr. O'Keefe is not required to appear, unquote. So fast forward a few years, what is going on here? Why are we now being required to appear before a grand jury of Hillsborough County on May 17th? With our track record of real and consequential journalism, you would think that authorities in New Hampshire would be thankful, grateful for the work that we're doing, but all we know, our grand jury summons is an attempt to intimidate us from doing more of this and to force us to disclose our undercover reporters' identities and our methods, which we will not disclose certain things there. The media has been obsessed with alleged collusion between Russia and the Trump campaign for 2 years, but Mueller's report showed there was none. What the media has ignored was the collusion in 2016 between the Bernie Sanders campaign and the Australian Labor Party, exposed by Veritas, that led to an FEC fine. They also seem to be ignoring the assault on journalism by the New Hampshire Attorney General's office. This is the contact information for one of the officials in that office that handed us the subpoena. We've tried asking him and his colleagues what is going on. Perhaps you could do the same.
Be a catalyst for change. Be brave. Do something.